What's up, YouTube? Yu-Gi-Oh! Tube with yet another mail day, and this is going to be a good one. We have piles upon piles of mail. Let's see what we got. Let's rip right into it. So the first package is from Mickleton, New Jersey, from Andrew. So let's see what we got here from Andrew from Mickleton, New Jersey. And here it is. It is a Machamp. So let's see how this looks. A Machamp first edition Shadowless. So I believe it was probably near mint or so. And actually, well, doesn't look too bad. I believe I got this one for somewhere around like $3 or so. So yeah, it does have a lot of corner wear here. You could really see it with a nice back black background of the playmat, but it has a lot of scratches. You can see that, right? All these scratches under light. But nonetheless, it was about $3. So, can't beat it for $3 shipped, right? Alright, next one is James. James from Ohio. Let's see what we got, James. And this one is a Yu-Gi-Oh card. Now, this is sweet. Okay, I'm excited for this one. It's a maximum 6. Now, what's so special about this card, right? Let's take a look. Maximum 6. It's got the gold ultra rare lettering, but it's not foil. And this is a card that was ultra rare in the set. And it's a very common misprint, but nonetheless a misprint. And as you can see, again, the ultra rare gold foiling, or gold text here, without the foiling. Pretty cool. Pretty cool from LODT, Light of Destruction. A very tough set to find. That's one of those really cool misprints. Very undervalued for what it is, I think, in my opinion. So that's cool. Starting off with some misprints. Let's see what this is. This one is from Dayton. Dayton from Georgia. Let's see what we got in here. Almost like half open. We have a Shadowless Raichu, a Shadowless Hitmonchan, Meowth Kangaskhan, Wigglytuff first edition Pinsir, a first edition Venomoth from Jungle, first edition Vileplume, Shadowless Nidoking, and a Dragonite. So let's just take a look at the Shadowless cards, because I think those were the ones that I bought this for. Now, this was a steal. Look at all these Jungle First Editions. But these were something absolutely absurd. I think it was like $17 or something. It was a buy it now. So, I mean, for the Shadowless cards, you can't really beat it, right? Let's see. And actually, aside from that bottom, you see a lot of bottom wear here, but the back, yes, the back is a little bit beat up. Not bad, though. I thought it'd be worse, to be honest. Take a look at the Hitmonchan, very scratched on the surface, but still, I mean, you gotta love these old school Pokemon cards. Oh, look at all those scratches. Lots and lots of scratches. This one was beat up, but hey, Hitmonchan's probably the least valuable. And the Raichu. Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's definitely some scratching going on here. You can see it down all the way in the card. You gotta wonder what these people did to these cards to just scratch them to oblivion. But nonetheless, three Shadowless cards with a lot of Jungle First Ed fossils. Or, first ed fossils. First ed cards. And a Dragonite to boot from Fossil. Pretty good. Not bad, not bad. Let's continue on. This one is from Japan. So, this one from Japan. Let's see what this is from Madoka. Madoka. Let's see. Alright, what do we got here? Let's see. Very well packaged, whatever this is. I'm genuinely curious. What do we got here? I've actually had quite a bit of good shipping from Japan and Asia specifically. So, let's see what it is. It's a bunch of cards. I think that is it. Yes, very nicely packaged. Thanks a lot. What are they? Oh, yeah. So this is what it was. It was Final Flame in Super Rare Holo. That is just epic. Final Flame. And this is a free card. Okay. Oh, a Toon Summon Skull. How about that? A rare Toon Summon Skull from BE1. So that's cool. Rare Japanese Toon Summon Skull. Cool, free cards. How about that? With a little message. Instagram. Follow them. There you go. Very cool. And the Final Flame, look at that alternate art. Just so cool. Just so different from the TCG version of LOB. And if you notice, no Eye of Anubis here sticker and no set number. Very old. Very cool. And let's do a UK, I believe, or Great Britain. This is Royal Mail. And let's see what's coming from. There is no return address. So what is this going to be? Oh, wow. Now that's a steal. Is it first edition? Yes, it is. This card was unbelievable. I should put a link in the description of how much this thing cost. This was an absolute steal. I mean, this thing, I think it was somewhere between 15 and 20 US dollars. Described as mint condition in first edition. It is the Euro print of Elemental Hero Bubble Man. So let's take a look. Take a gander. Well, it's got just a little bit of edge wear on the top, but other than that, boy oh boy, does this look good. Hardly an ultimate rare square on the back, and this thing is a gradable card. You know, this could be definitely a PSA 9 in my opinion. Very sharp corners, great back, not a lot of indentation from the ultimate rare. Look at that card, and look at it just shine. Wow, first edition Cybernetic Revolution. Now that's what you call a steal. We're not even going to put that back. We're just going to leave that over the side. That's very sweet. Here's another one from Alex. Alex from Jersey City, New Jersey. Jersey City, New Jersey. How about this one? Red Eyes Black Dragon. But what's so special about this Red Eyes? Look at the centering. Look at how it's cut. And honestly, well, I was going to say the condition not looking too bad, but man, it's really not looking too bad. Look at this card. The complete top border shaved off. And it's actually crazy because it's rounded here. Rounded edges. So this is from Legendary Collections, Joey's World, ultra rare, and look at the back, everybody. Look at the back of this card. Wow. You talk about miscut cards. This one, definitely miscut. I want to grade this. I definitely want to get that miscut grade. OC, MC, either one would work with me. So very cool misprints and miscut cards here in this mail day, as well as some OCG, some Pokemon, some GX. We got it all today. Got it all. Next one from Krasnoik in Forest Grove, Oregon. Let's see what we got here. Coming all the way from Oregon. Take out the scissors. Wow. Here's the package. Oh, there's the package. Here is the package. All right, let's see what we got here. Okay, well, it is a Megamore from TP4, super rare. Here's two of them. It is a Luminous Soldier and a DD Warrior, tournament pack ultra rares. And the other two are a Megamorph and a Fiend Mega Cyber. And that's from Tournament Pack 4 and Tournament Pack 4. Let's see how they look. Tournament Pack Super Rares. Let's see what we got. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Now that looks great. That looks awesome. Yep, that will do. That's good. Let's check the Megamorph. The Megamorph. Stunning condition, everybody. Great. Great stuff here. The Megamorph. Look at that. Look at the foil. Very nice. And then here's the two biggies. Let's go to the Luminous Soldier Tournament Pack 5. Ultra rare. Yeah, that looks flawless, everybody. That looks flawless. Very nice. Very, very nice. Yes, yes, yes. Beautiful. And the last one, DD Warrior. Let's see what we got here. DD Warrior. Looks pretty good, but if you look here, what a shame. You've got an indent, and it looks like it was from the Ultra Pro Circle. So that's not good at all. There it is. You can see the indent right there on the DD Warrior. Shame, because otherwise the card... Well, no. No. Here we go. You can see there is a surface scratch all down the top of the card. Right here, you'll see it. Not too happy with that one. Not too happy. I'm going to see what we can do on this one. Not too good. Definitely not. I wouldn't even say almost near mint, unfortunately. 3 out of 4 good, but... DD Warrior by far was the most expensive card there, so not too happy about that one as much. So let's move on here. Ray B from Hawaii. Let's take out the scissors. We got another one of these. Alright, so it looks like a Red Eyes Black Flare Metal. Let's just check the condition out, see if there's any scratches on the surface, which I'm sure there are. This card, one of the hardest cards to find in mint condition. And actually, I think this is the person on Instagram from Hawaii. Let's see. He said this card with no scratches, mint condition. Let's see if it was mint. Let's take a look. Double, triple sleeve, however you want to call it. Here we go. Quadruple sleeve. Well, how about that packaging, huh? Wow, that's a lot of sleeves. And do we have scratching? I don't see any. I don't see any scratching. I see sharp edges. I see sharp corners. And I don't see any scratching. Yeah. I overpaid for this one. I paid much more than what the Near Mint was going for. Quite a bit premium. Maybe almost double of what a Near Mint price was going for. So I was expecting the best, but this looks to be as advertised. Certainly looks really good. Let's check the back. Really good, but there is a little bit here on the corner. You can see that corner? Just a bit of a dot. You know, let's see. Try and zoom in and actually show you guys what I'm talking about. See if we can get right there. Right there. In that corner, you see there's a little dot. Just a little dot. I don't know if that's going to be enough to hinder it to a PSA 9. But nonetheless, this card, the foil, no scratches. It's a scratch-free foil. Very, very hard to find without scratches. Very happy with that one. I'll take it. It's got a 10 shot. I don't know if it's going to get it. But certainly, there's the opportunity. Let's continue on here. We have MTG first from Maryland. Magic the Gathering first from Maryland. Here we go. And okay. Not going to like this one too much. What happened here was these were first edition cards. These were first edition cards. And as we see, they're not first edition, so we're going to have to return these for sure. These are just channelless cards, and that's the condition. Granted, they're not too bad, but I believe the title said channelless, but the pictures showed first edition, and there's a lot of scratching here too. So this does not match the picture. It was first edition in the pictures, and this is what you get sometimes. You get this kind of deceptive. Oh, and look at all the foil scratching up here. This is not going to do. So that is definitely going to be a return. No questions about it here. Definitely not as described. Not even close to happy with these. Let's just sort this out 1 second. Okay, yeah, so what happened again? Title said channelless, picture had first edition, relatively cheap cards, and as we see, they don't even match the picture, and that again, that's not going to do. So that'll be a return for sure. Not only that, is the condition just wasn't good. So we continue on here, two packages to go, and let's try this one. So this one was from Richard in Virginia. All right, Richard, we have a pack of cards here, and we also have a free card as well. What kind of pack is this, huh? This is pretty cool stuff. I've got an idea. This looks awesome. And there it is, a first edition Asian English Blue Eyes White Dragon pack. First edition Asian English. That is just awesome. Now, how cool is that? How cool is that? That's very cool. All right. Yeah, that's just really cool. Okay, and he apparently added a free marshmallow glasses. Very cool, too. All right. And what do we got here? The last ones are Legends in Sports. And so this one should be a very good package. I pay premium for these cards. This should be a decent chunk of them. Here we go. Legends of Sports. Let's see what it is. Just trying to open this up. Alrighty. Here it is. Oh, cool. 4 Yu-Gi-Oh! Auctions 1. Thanks, Tim, from Legends of Sports. Wow, nice handwriting, you gotta say that, huh? Alright, Premature Burial, Buster Blader, Beast of Tal War, Mask of Restrict. Let's see. Here's the Premature Burial. All these were described as mint condition. Will they be mint? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's looking mint. Minty fresh. Premature Burial. I don't know what's going on with this camera. Let's zoom it out a little bit. And it looks pretty good. Pretty good, yeah. Yeah, that looks to be a PSA 10 candidate. So far, one for one. Let's take a look here. Buster Blader, Pharaoh's Servant, first edition. Again, if this camera's kind of freaking out, I just gotta see what's going on. I mean, I don't know how to change it. The Buster Blader looks good. It looks good. I'm a little curious as to what's going on here. I don't know if that's a bend. I don't know if it's a fold. Oh, boy. Yeah, there's definitely something going on here. Yeah. Yeah, this is... I would not say this is near mint to mint. Let's see if we can get it. Yeah. Look, there's a big line, like a fold, actually coming down the Konami symbol. And I just don't know if that's... I mean, because this one was very expensive. It looks just like a fold. Again... You could see it right there. I don't know. You know, I don't agree with this valuation. I don't agree with this being near mint to mint. I mean, that looks really ugly. Oh boy. Well, not liking that one too much. That one I think might be a return, so we'll leave that out here. Here's a Beast of Tal War. Hopefully this one's a little bit better. Yeah, and I mean, this is much better. I mean, this is a great, great looking card. A wonderful looking card here. Yeah, no flaws on this one. Beast of Tal War, that's good to go. Great looking card. And Mask of Restrict. Let's see what we got here. Another solid looking card, but I am seeing again a little bit of something on this top left corner, almost a line going down. Yeah, and again, I see it on the back here. There's kind of like lines going down the card. Now, they're not necessarily, you know. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, there's surface lines, which is not appealing to the eye. Let's take a look. Again, you can see it's almost like a bend. You know, I'm not sure. We'll put that with the Buster Blader. All right, here's another one. Legends and Sports. Let's try this one out. This one's a box, so this is going to be a bit more interesting. Okay. Here it is, and it's again 6 auctions, eBay. Thanks again, Tim, Legends and Sports. All right, well, seems like a nice enough guy based on his notes. But let's see. What exactly is going on here? very nicely packaged, I will say that too. Very tightly packaged. But hey, with the other thing, you know, that's why you do it, right? Okay. That's why you open them on camera and kind of see what you get condition-wise. As you can see, a lot of these cards are really coming up from their respective top loaders. Now, Grave Robber. This was supposedly in light play to near mint, so I'm not expecting too much here. And ironically, I'm seeing no issues. Wow. Yeah, ironically, this thing looks phenomenal on first glance. So I was expecting that not to be so good, but let's take a look at this one. These are all first editions, as always. Yeah, I mean, I'm really seeing no issues. Take a look. Oh, there, yep. There it is. There it is. Alright, well, that's why I described it like that. Okay. Let's move on here to Dimensional Fusion. Yeah, that looks great. Looks phenomenal. The back also looks phenomenal. Yeah. Yeah, this thing is great. Confiscation. First glance, looks great. And the back, looks great. Painful choice. Phenomenal as well. And the back, also looking good. And we have three of these whales, which we'll get to. I'll just do these off camera. That'll do it. Yu-Gi-Oh! Tube, signing out.